all the things that we are told about quantum mechanics is wrong. I writing now an article that I say, I call it, how could we have been so wrong for so long about quantum mechanics? All the things that we have been told, telling about quantum mechanics to many in the streets, look, quantum mechanics is such a mysterious theory. The particles can be at the same time at two different locations.
Right.
There is no reality there. There is no reason there because two atoms for no reason behave differently. So the world, according to this story, is so illogical that people, philosophers and writers now say that the whole, we have to look at the world as something completely uncertain because that is what quantum mechanics tells us about. And that story is wrong. Okay? So this is my main mission, to show that the way that we have thought about quantum mechanics is really wrong and we have to think about it in a new way. Now, once you think about it in this new way and you learn to look at quantum systems without disturbing them, you find a beautiful new reality that can be checked only by this kind of weak measurement. And I found a host of new phenomena that is related to this reality. Perhaps the most entertaining phenomena is that I call the quantum Cheshire effect. You know, the story about Alice in Wonderland that was written by Curt, right? And this Alice comes to this beautiful world. She can talk to animals there. And she met a cat. She talks to the cat. And after a while, the cat gets angry and disappears. But it disappears in a very strange way. First, the tail disappears. Then the body disappears. Then the face disappears. And only a smile is left. And Alice thinks to herself, I've many times seen a cat without a smile. But what could be a smile without a cat? Doesn't make sense. So everybody that reads this, including me, when I read it in high school, I thought that Lewis Carroll was crazy to talk about a smile without a cat. But it turns out that quantum mechanics tells us that that can really happen. What I've shown is there is a very interesting effect. You take a particle like a neutron that has a property that's called the spin. The neutron can rotate around itself and produce a magnetic moment. That rotation is called the spin. And it turns out that it's possible to do an experiment where you send the electron in one side and the spin leads the electron and moves by itself on the other side, and then they join again. So the spin is like the smile of the cat that can leave the neutron, although everybody thought the neutron can never exist without the spin, and the spin cannot exist without the neutron. This is one of the kind of new phenomena that I found once I started to think correctly by using pre and post selection. And there are many, many other effects that something we call super oscillations and quantum work that are new directions in mathematics that came out of this world. And there are many other beautiful results, especially that when you have an electron and you do pre and post selection, you find that the electron can have together with it a pair of another electron and a counter electron that has a negative mass and the opposite charge. And if you only do with measurement, you see those new kinds of entities that I call counter particles. So there are beautiful new phenomena that you discover once you think properly about quantum mechanics. So the first idea is when you have two atoms that are exactly the same, but they behave later differently, you say that this later experiment tells you that in fact, from the beginning, the two atoms were different, but you couldn't find it in the past, you can only find it in the future. And I reformulated quantum mechanics by saying that in order to describe the present, in classical physics, to describe fully the present, it's enough to know the initial conditions in the past. In quantum mechanics, in order to describe fully the pattern in the present, you must do two experiments. One before that give you one boundary condition, the past, the wave function that you found before propagates to the present. And later you do another experiment that gets different results for one atom and the other. That different result give you another boundary condition, and that new thing that is called the wave is propagated back from the future to the present. And both information from the past and from the future, which can happen only quantum mechanically, because logically, once you know the past, there is no new information in the future. But in quantum mechanics, you have new information in the future, and both informations are relevant in the present, provided you do only with measurement to check them. Okay, that is, in a nutshell, the ideas that I want to discuss in this interview. So
that's perfect. So I want to see if I'm understanding correctly.
Okay.
Are you specifying right now the two-state vector formalism?
Yes. In quantum mechanics, a pattern is described by a vector in Hilbert space. That vector in the Schrödinger representation is described by a wave. And the Heisenberg representation is described by some observable that tell you what this vector is. But anyhow, you have a vector that comes from the measurement in the past. It propagates according to the Schrödinger or Heisenberg expression of motion to the present. Then, later, you do another experiment that distinguishes between the two particles that started in the same initial condition. One of them moves to the right and the other moves to the left. If you take only those that move to the right, it gives you another boundary condition, another vector. This will send it back from the future to the present. And both vectors, on equal terms, tell you the full information about the present.
I don't usually stop mid-conversation to talk about sleep, but I've been using something that's made an appreciable difference. It's called Evening Being by Verso. Now, if you're like me, getting quality sleep while juggling work and stress and everything else isn't exactly straightforward. I've tried various routines. By the way, I have my sleep hygiene on point, like avoiding screens, for instance, after a certain time and don't eat after a certain time. But sometimes the stress accumulates. It does this for all of us, and deep sleep gets harder. Evening Being uses research-backed ingredients that help your body calm and active mind. This formula is melatonin-free, by the way, which means there's no dependencies or morning grogginess. I know some people get that. This formula also helps improve deep and REM sleep cycles and supports staying asleep longer. Basically, it tells your body to relax and to wake less. Since taking it, I and my wife have noticed that we've fallen asleep faster, so sleep latency is lower. I also feel more refreshed, my energy is distinctly more stable throughout the day, and I'm discernibly quicker mentally. I haven't changed anything else about my supplement regimen. I've just added this to my nighttime routine and it's helped me sleep consistently without forcing it. Something else to note is that Verso third-party tests every batch and publishes the results. This matters to me personally because I want to know exactly what I'm getting. If you're looking to dial in your sleep quality and recovery and wake up actually rested, then check it out. Head to evening.ver.so/TOE and use the code TOE to get 15% off your first order. That's evening.ver.so/TOE. Again, the code is TOE. Thanks to Verso for sponsoring this episode.